You hate social media, don't you? You really hate it. All the noise, the silly videos, the quotes, the experts. Well, this week on Motivation and Confidence, we're going to talk about the three reasons why you hate social media. Stay tuned. You're now tuned into Motivation and Confidence, where we help you do your daily best. And I'm your host, Tom Danger. Back this week with a new episode. And this week we're going to switch it up, and the subject is three reasons why you hate social media. Three reasons why you hate social media. And before we go any further, please like, subscribe, and share. If there are particular subjects that you'd like for us to discuss, please visit the website contact section. TomDanger.com, TomDanger.com. If you're interested in coaching, please also hit the contact page and fill it out, and I'll get back to you. I have a couple of slots left open for this month, and we'll take it from there. But I hear a lot of people talk about how much they dislike social media. And although you may dislike social media, you always want to reap the rewards of social media. You want the following. You want the networking ability. You want the access to information. But you don't want to be judged. And that's one of the biggest things, or one of the biggest reasons why you don't like social media. You feel this pressure to keep up with information that's being pushed out in seconds. And although the information, well, not necessarily information, but the entertainment that appears on social media may not be to your liking, you have to figure out how to change the channel. It doesn't matter where you go, you can't please everyone. So you have to look at it as a way for you to find like-minded people such as yourself. And one of the reasons why you hate social media is because of the noise. It's so hard to cut through the noise. It's just people who do random things. You have a legitimate idea. You want to bring your business or hobby or passion for something to various platforms. And you think that it should be getting attention. It should be getting likes and comments. And then you have someone who can do something real silly, and all of a sudden it's a million views. But don't focus on the views or the likes, so to speak. Focus on the connection. If you enjoy pickles, I love pickles, and you wanted to create a page dedicated to nothing but pickles, and you find one other human being on this planet, in which I'm pretty sure there'll be more than one person, who enjoys pickles, who enjoys the process of making pickles, the brining process, the packaging process, the various condiments, or the various ways in which pickles could be used, and the regions and the herbs, and you know, all these different things that go into a pickle making process. Create that platform so that you could find those people to talk about that. Right now, in between that, you're going to have people screaming and yelling and voicing their opinions on how much they may hate pickles. You may find people who are upset about their relationships, but understand that you always have the ability to do a couple of things. If you get people on your page that are just talking trash, block them. If you have content on any platform that you don't want to see, they have settings to where you can adjust it so that you don't see any more content like that, especially on Instagram. You can say, you know, show less of this and show more of that. You know, you can do that. And I believe you could also do it on TikTok. You also want to identify which platforms you enjoy the most. Okay. Are you an introvert or are you an extrovert? Are you an introvert and you want to be on camera and in pictures and always in front of people, blah, blah, blah? Or are you an introvert and you feel more comfortable going on Twitter to where you can just have some sort of image and just express your emotions, or starting engaging in conversations with people that you may or may not know? That doesn't mean that you need to get online and debate with people, right? And that's a great segue into the second reason why you hate social media, is because everyone is an expert. You ever notice that? Like, you get online and everybody has the answer to everything. Everybody, you know, they just know. Everybody knows content strategies. Everyone knows how to lose weight. Everyone knows how to create passive income. Everyone knows how to fix your relationship. Everyone knows how to become a millionaire. So everybody knows. And while so many people create the illusion, if everybody knew, I think more of us would be in a better place. But it all depends on how you receive the information and the credibility of the source. You know, there's such a thing as vanity metrics, to where a person can create a profile, make it look as if they have a lot of followers, make it look as if they have engagement, and have no idea or don't really have the background to speak on the things that they're speaking on. However, they have an opinion, but they put a price tag on something and they call themselves an expert. In my hood, we call that an old school hustler or a con man. Not even a hustler, that's a con man or con person. Right, a person that's just trying to con you into something to make you believe that you're going to get more for less, right? So you want to, like, it's like vetting, right? It's like just doing your background check. Like, check what people are actually saying in the comments about these people. And you can see in the comments whether or not it's just fake random stuff. And if you really want to go out on a limb, send the person a message and ask them a question to see how they respond. And then check your sources. You know, you don't just want to go at one source. Like, see if what that person is saying is consistent amongst other experts in that field. Okay? And the third reason, and it's to circle back, is just the level of noise. The internet can be so noisy. Social media can be so noisy that it's just irritating. Like, you turn it on and it's just, you know, bells and whistles and notifications and scammers in your inbox and people leaving rude comments on your page. And it begins to feel like a rat race to get things done, as opposed to the tool that it should be, right? The tool is for you to network. The tool is for you to study. The tool is for you to do research. And the tool, as it was originally created, is a form of entertainment. And what each of us find different in studying is subject matter. We share difference in opinions when it comes to entertainment. Certain jokes that we find funny, other people may not find funny. But you control social media. Social media does not control you. You control what you want to see. You control what you want to hear. You control how often you can be notified. You can turn off all the notifications for all your social media so that you don't feel like it's controlling you to where you have to grab your phone and take a look at it when you get a notification. You don't. You can turn it all off. Right? Use social media as a tool to network, build community, learn, and help other people. This is Motivation and Confidence, where we help you do your daily best.